Assalamu alaikum, my dear ladies and gentlemen. Today I am going to discuss with you the anatomy of human wrist. In human anatomy, the wrist is variously defined as the carpus or carpal bone, the complex of 8 bones forming the proximal skeleton segment of the hand, the wrist joint or radiocarpal joint, the joint between the radius and the carpus, and the anatomical region surrounding the carpus, including the distal parts of the bones of the forearm and the proximal parts of the metacarpus of pyometacarpal bone, and the series of joints between these bones, thus referred to as wrist joint. The region also include the carpal tunnel, the anatomical snuff box, bracelet lines, the plexus retinaculum and extensor retinaculum. A human swing the wrist in the center, the carpal bone sometimes included in the definition of the wrist. In Latin, the wrist are called articulatio radiocarpalis. Now we are going to discuss the anatomical terminology of the wrist. As a consequence of these various definitions, fracture to the carpal bone are referred to as carpal fracture, while fractures such as distal radius fracture are often considered fracture but to a wrist. Now we are going to discuss the structure of the wrist. The distal radio ulnar joint is a fused joint located between the bones of the forearm. The radius and the ulna form by the heat of the ulna and the ulnar notch of the radius. This joint is separated from the radiocarpal joint by an articular disc lying between the radius and the styloid process of the ulna. The capsule of the joints is lax and extends from the inferior sesipom recess to the ulnar shaft together with the proximal radio ulnar joint. The distal radio ulnar joint permits pronation and supination. The radiocarpal joint or wrist joint is ellipsoid joint formed by the radius and the articular disc proximally and the proximal row of the carpal bone distally. The carpal bone on the ulnar side only make intermittent contact with the proximal side. The tricuspid only makes contact during ulnar abduction. The capsule lacks an unbranch, is thin on the dorsal side and can contain a synovial fold. The capsule is continuous with the midcarpal joint and strengthened by numerous ligaments, including the palmar and dorsal radiocarpal ligaments and the ulnar radial collateral ligaments. The parts forming the radiocarpal joints are the lower end of the radius and under surface of the articular discs above, and the scaphoid lunate and tricuspid bone below. The articular surface of the radius and the under surface of the articular discs form together a transversely elliptical concave surface. The receiving cavity, the superior articular surface of the scaphoid lunate and tricuspid form a smooth convex surface. The condyle which is received in the concavity carpal bone is of the hand, proximal A scaphoid, B lunate, C tricuspid, D fusiform, distal E trapezium, F trapezoid, G capitate, H hamate. In the hand proper, a total of 13 bone form part of the wrist: 8 carpal bones, scaphoid, lunate, tricuspid, fusiform, trapezium, trapezoid, capitate, and hamate, and 5 metacarpal bones: the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth metacarpal bone. The midcarpal joint in the S-shaped joint space separating the proximal and distal row of the carpal bone. The intercarpal joint between the bones of each row are strengthened by the radiate carpal and physio-hamate ligament, and the palmar interosseous and dorsal intercarpal ligament. Some degree of mobility is possible between the bones of the proximal row, while the bones of the distal row are connected to each other and to the metacarpal bone at the carpometacarpal joint by strong ligament. The physio metacarpal and palmar and dorsal carpometacarpal ligaments that makes a functional entity of these bone. Additionally, the joints between the bases of metacarpal bone, the intermetacarpal articulation, are strengthened by dorsal intersocies and palmar intermittent carpal ligaments articulation. The radiocarpal, intercarpal, midcarpal, carpo metacarpal and intermetacarpal joints are often intercommunicate through a common synovial cavity called articulation, articulate surface. It has two articular surfaces named proximal and distal articulate articular surface. The proximal articular surface is made up of lower end apparatus and triangular articular discs of the inferior radio ulnar. On the other hand, the distal articular surface is made up of the proximal surface of the scaphoid, trapezoidal and lunate bone. Now we are going to discuss function of the wrist. Number one, movement. The extensic hand muscles are located in the forearm where their bilis from the proximal fleshy roundness. When contracted, most of the tendon of these muscles are prevented from standing up like taut bowstring around the wrist by passing under the flexor retinaculum on the palmar side and the extensor retinaculum on the dorsal side. On the palmar side, the carpal bone from the carpal tunnel through which some of the flexor tendon pass in the tendon sheath that enables them to slide back and forth through the narrow passageway. Starting from the mid position of the hand, the movement permitted in the wrist proper are muscle in order of importance. Now we are going to discuss marginal movement. Radial deviation abduction movement toward the thumb and ulnar deviation abduction movement toward the little finger. These movements take place about a dorso palmar axis back to front at the radiocarpal and midcarpal joint passing through the cavitate bone. Radial abduction extensor cavi. Radial longus abduction pollicis, longus extensor pollicis, longus flexor carpi, radialis flexor pollicis, longus ulnar abduction extensor carpi, ulnaris flexor carpi, ulnaris extensor digitorum extensor digiti minimi. Now we are going to discuss movement in the plane of the hand, flexion, palmar flexion, tilting toward the palm and extension, dorsiflexion tilting toward the back of the hand. These movements take place through a transverse axis passing through the cavitate bone. Palmar flexion is the most powerful of these movements because the flexor, especially the finger flexor, are considerably stronger than extension. Now we are going to discuss extension. Extension is extended digitorum, extensor carpi, radialis longus, extensor carpi, radialis brevis, extensor indicus, extensor pollicis, longus, extensor digiti minimi, extensor carpi, ulnaris. Now we are going to discuss palmar flexion. Palmar flexion is flexor digitorum superficialis, flexor digitorum profundus, flexor carpi, ulnaris, flexor pollicis, longus, flexor carpi, radialis, abductor pollicis, longus. Intermediate or combined movement of the wrist. However, movement at the wrist cannot be properly described without including movement in the distal radio ulnar joint, in which the rotary action of the supination and pronation occur. And this joint is therefore normally regarded as a part of the wrist. Now we are going to discuss clinical significance of the wrist. So in clinics, wrist pain has a number of causes including carpal tunnel syndrome, ganglion cysts and osteoarthritis. Tests such as Phelan test involve palmar flexion at the wrist. The hand may be deviated at the wrist in same conditions such as rheumatoid arthritis, ossification,